I feel like I've spent 3 months inside a tin can.
Okay. What do you say we hop on down to Mexico, Captain?
Margaritas on the beach?
More like Rangers in red berets. Tighten up your panties. We're going supersonic.
Colonel McCall runs this badge training camp, and Kim suspects he's part of the conspiracy. He won't be running into many intellectuals down there. Mostly black ops, knuckle draggers. This could be another one of that blonde's con jobs.
I trust her.
Uh-huh. You save her life, and she splits.
Jealous, Major?
Just get in the damn boat.
Near the watchtower. Now, search.
Rookies think they're goddamn John Rambo.
Where the fuck did McCall get those fools from anyway?
Wherever it was, he sure assembled one hell of a crew.
Any news of number 13?
Oh, the mongoose will surely take care of him. Let's not bother number 1 with this problem.
In any case, 13 has no power to disrupt the plan. My men are standing by, General Stanwell. He's been causing quite a ruckus since his resurrection, but our first maneuvers are going ahead as planned.
I admire your optimism, Colonel McCall. Now, how about a tour of the camp? I'd like to have a look at our weapon stock.
Certainly, General. Right this way.
Now find McCall's tent and plant the bug.
Whatever happened to him?
I think General Carrington hired him. That was the last I heard. I got it! Fly! His name was Jason Fly!
Hey, Fly! I'm out on leave tonight, so don't make me look bad while I'm out. Just because you won yesterday's exercise doesn't make you a hero around here.
Steve Rowland, the man whose identity I took.
You can fly, you can hide, you can close your mind, but I'm still on the run.
Apparently McCall's in the same tent he used in Desert Storm. That should give you an idea of what it looks like. Plant the bug behind the intercom.
No one can see us here. You want one?
No, thanks.
Saving your lungs for the maneuvers?
Yeah, I can't wait for the action to start.
It's just a simulation, you know.
I have a feeling there'll be more to it than we expect.
Gather round, gentlemen. This is number 11. Do you read me?
Affirmative. Go ahead, number 3.
Good evening, number 1. President Galbraith still believes in a simulated state of war and has just authorized the SPADs to supervise the army during the maneuvers. Over.
Good. Number 5.
I'll be receiving the list of those supporting the cause tomorrow. Number 9.
Arms shipment will arrive tonight. My men are eager to serve the cause. Over.
Excellent. What about number 13?
I have his military file here. I removed it from the Pentagon to block the FBI's investigation.
Good. As for number 17, no need to continue the search. I have something here that she will definitely come and claim. This meeting is adjourned, gentlemen.
I'll walk you out.
Privileged to meet you, Colonel McCall.
He's even more impatient than his men, isn't he, Colonel?
Very perceptive of you, General.
I just got all that on tape. Now find Roland's file. You can blow this thing wide open.
Thank you.
don't know where McCall plans to send his stock of weapons, but we're gonna blow it up. Nice work. Now get back to the boat.
What the hell's going on?
I told him not to smoke around the hangar. Watch out! They could go again!
Thank you.
The Spaz found the boat. Find another way out.
Colonel, I swear I saw him!
Steve Rowland's been dead a long time, and I don't believe in ghosts, Sergeant Bauer. Carry on!
Yes, sir, Colonel!
Son of a bitch, he's gonna pay for this! Destroy him! Thirteen! Can you hear me? Number One underestimated your skills. He wants to reintegrate you into the group. Drop your weapon, man! Let's talk about this!
Your only way out.
Duty officer requested at Central.
Oh! Oh!
Closing security hatches.
Oh!
tapping, grinding, or welding. Missile movement in progress. Petty Officer First Class Baker, report to gangway. Chief Petty Officer, Michel Grove, report to Section E. Officer on duty, report to deck. USS Patriot, closing hatch in 15 minutes. Captain Edelbright, now boarding. Casting off.